The wisdom teeth are thought to have evolved for catching, killing, and eating uncooked prey, which would make them obsolete for us in the 21st century. So according to American Association of Oral Maxillofacial Surgeon website, if left in the mouth, the impacted wisdom tooth may damage the neighboring teeth and nerves or become infected, possibly inviting systemic infections and disease as the bacteria travel through the bloodstream from your mouth to other organs in your body. I'm Dr. Scott Lim, your friendly neighborhood dentist. Please hit the like and subscribe button below to give me more invisible support to produce more dental videos for you. Studies suggest that not more than 12% of infections lead to infections or damage the adjacent teeth, roughly the same incidence as appendicitis. So these days, oral surgery to remove the wisdom teeth is the standard practice, almost a rite of passage for the young adults. But it's not always necessary though. Still, just because your wisdom teeth aren't a source of pain doesn't mean that there's nothing wrong. The teeth could be stuck or impacted. That means that they can't break through the jaw into your mouth, or maybe your mouth is too small to make room for them. Or the teeth could be grooving at an angle to other teeth. They can damage the tooth next door if they push against it. Some dentists take out healthy molars to prevent problems later on. As you age, the bones in your mouth gets harder. That makes the teeth tougher to remove, and for you, the wound will take longer to heal. If you wait, you can have problems after the surgery that range from heavy bleeding and fractured teeth to severe numbness and minor loss of movement in your jaw. These troubles could last a few days or a lifetime. So when is removal needed? When wisdom teeth show problems or actually shows that they might be down the line, they need to come out. So according to the ADA, the wisdom teeth removal may be necessary if you experience changes in the areas of those teeth, such as the pain due to the tooth decay or the gum disease surrounding the wisdom tooth, repeated infection of the soft tissue surrounding the wisdom tooth, the fluid filled sac, or we call it cyst. Cysts can form around the new teeth. If they're untreated, they can hold up your jaw and damage the nerves, damage the nearby teeth. Gum disease, the tissue surrounding the area can swell and be painful and may be difficult to clean. Extensive tooth decay of the wisdom tooth and the adjacent tooth. Or you feel it's difficult to clean, and the advantages of early treatment would be the wisdom tooth being easier to remove due to the softer bone, reduced risk of damage to adjacent tooth, the healing will be faster, and also can prevent crowding of the back teeth, and so preventing the wisdom tooth from becoming stuck in the jaw, and also to prevent the red swollen painful gums which is caused by a flap of skin around the wisdom tooth that has only partially come in, and also to prevent gum disease or tooth decay in the wisdom tooth, which may be harder to clean than other teeth, or in the teeth and jaw in the area of the wisdom tooth. And you may be asking, if I don't do any treatment, what will happen? There might be worsening of the tooth decay and gum diseases to both the wisdom tooth and its adjacent tooth. The cyst might enlarge to damage the adjacent teeth, as well as the nerves, the bone resorption or jaw weakening, etc. So a dentist will look at the shape of your mouth and the position of the wisdom tooth to make a decision. And your age plays a role too. Still not ready to part ways with the tooth that gives you wisdom? You can ask your dentist to explain what they see with your teeth. In many cases, you can wait for several months to see if things can change before making your decision. But if you have pain or notice swelling or a bad odor near your back teeth, it might be a time for a second look. And that's all for today. Hope the information above helps you in some way. Do drop by any comments in the comment box below, and I would like to hear from you more. Thank you, and see you in my next episode.